Now we go all the way ahead to August of 1960, when Frances Clare, who was now, let me see, a year old or so, I forget, when Frances Clare and your dad visited us. Just a few shots of that little visit. A cutie, anyhow, really a cutie. Look at her smile. Now we have a glimpse of Linda with Kathy in April 1961. This is nearly a year ahead. Just a glimpse, a few seconds. You can see how she's growing. Now, April 61. Well, here we are in April 1962, Easter. My, how everybody's grown. You probably remember those dogs, I don't. And let me see, we're living on 5th Street in Roselle at that time, I believe. And who have we got here? February the 2nd, 1963. This was in your house. Bruce was at home 5 days old. Well, we'll see Bruce when he was just a wee-un. Just got home, I guess. Here we go forward a year, and then we have to sit. Bruce's baptismal reception. And there's a darling little boy with his aunt Muriel. Muriel, as you know, is the daughter of your Aunt Edith. So she's your first cousin. That's true, isn't it? Yes. First cousin. There's Muriel's husband, Dennis Bruce, who I think was the godfather. Anybody can tell where the name Bruce came from, can't they? There's Francis. There's a guest of honor with his cousin Muriel. Jim. Maggie, of course. Granny. There's the old backyard, which gave everybody a great deal of pleasure, I presume. Here we are in September at a Scottish picnic. I forget just where it was, possibly up in Scotch Plains or someplace. Oh boy, there's Bruce. That's in September of 63. Looks as though Bruce is a good deal older. The dad's in good form. Here are the Bruces again. Ah. Oh, I think this is the one in which we get Alec doing a great jump. Everybody else is good jumpers. Great. This is in our backyard, of course, as you know. Here comes Alec. Never the greatest athlete. And here are the Bruces again. And the Bruce. And James Snodgrass, a junior. I mean, well, yes, he was a junior at that time. Your granddad was alive. So young Jim was the third, wasn't he? Very funny, kid. Very funny. Now, I think this is Kathy's 10th birthday party. She had quite a few of those things, if you remember. Well, we're all going to a Scottish picnic in Farchers Grove, Springfield. Okay, it's September the 6th, 1965, Labor Day. Scottish picnic, Farchers Grove, it says. It says, we the Cummings, the Snodgrasses, the McGowans, Margie Hunt, Pipers, Caberstrowing, Eats and Talk. Oh, there's Doreen McGowan. And that, of course, is Linda. Here are members of the Cumming family. We don't need to see any more Pipers. Let's see what else we have on this reel. Well, this gives you an idea of how we amused ourselves way back then.
There's Jim.
Is this on? Yes, this is on. Yeah, there's Jim. There are the Scottish hats.
It's Jim tossing the caber, or trying to.
Trying to toss the caber.
It was heavy.
It takes a lot of experience to do it. He didn't manage, but he made a good try.
Nick,
in fact, it is Christmas 1965. And it appears to be the house on, yeah, it appears to be your house. I haven't seen this reel for a while. I'll just let it run until it runs out of the Snodgrass family. It's now April 1966, and here comes your Aunt Edith, your father's sister Edith, and his niece Muriel. There's Mom. Jimmy McGowan. This is on Coolidge Road, Elizabeth. Your Auntie May. Mrs. McGowan, Carmel. And your close relatives. Carmel, Edith, and your sister Anna, or May. Your dad, as merry as ever.